So how does the keyboard work on the iPad, and what is the best keyboard for your iPad in 2021? Is it heavy or is it expensive? Is the key travel good? And do you actually need one or not? Hello everyone, if we are meeting for the first time, I go by Nibs, and today I will be explaining all you need to know about how to use your iPads with a keyboard and which keyboard is best with your iPad. This may be a long video, so please bear with me till the end, or you can head directly to the chapter that's most interesting to you. Before we start, please make sure to hit that subscribe button and hit the like and notification bell if you're interested in this subject and any subject that's related to using your iPad as your only computer. So, do you need a keyboard in the first place? Actually, you need to answer that question yourself, but if your daily typing doesn't exceed a couple emails, web browsing, and some messaging, then you can totally and comfortably survive with the touch virtual keyboard on your screen, or better yet, with dictation. And I do actually use dictation a lot when it's a very quick text. But on the other hand, if you are a businessman or a student or maybe a blogger, meaning you need to type a lot, then yes, of course you need one, and it better be good. And for those of you who need a keyboard, apparently you care about the price, the build quality, keystroking sound and feel, and the key travel. Well, cheer up guys, I found the perfect keyboard and it's this. Yes, I am serious my friends, it is the best keyboard for the iPad, and I will tell you why after you hit that like button and subscribe. Now, if you don't have a keyboard yet and you're interested in buying that magic keyboard or its Logitech replacement for a couple hundred bucks, then it's okay, I love these keyboards. They look good, they're neat, they're nice. But if you're not interested in paying that much money and you need a very good keyboard, then this should be your first and best option. Let's answer my questions again. Keystroke sounds and feels are perfect, it's the same old iMac keyboard we all love and enjoy. And the key travel is good since it's a full-size keyboard, so no worries about that. The build quality is perfect, it's made of aluminum and it has the neat design and typing angle. Plus, it's fully wireless and I got it secondhand for $20 only. What more do you want? I've seen almost every keyboard review out there and it's too many details and nonsense. This is more than perfect for your workflow. And it's movable, so it's never in your way when you don't need it. Plus, you probably already have it because you had an iMac or a Mac Mini or whatever Mac you ever had. So you already have it at home, you're not paying for this. So you can just connect to it and start using it. If you don't, then you can buy this amazing build quality secondhand for a cheap price like I did. Let me show you how amazing it is to use this keyboard with your iPad. Okay guys, so before I start, the first thing you need to know is that iOS 15 added to the hardware keyboard options. So before iOS 15, you could only use the command button to make actions. So if you long press on command, it will show you a menu of all the shortcuts you can use in your keyboard. But after iOS 15, now you should use the function key in universal mode. And let me explain this. Now the function key makes system commands which are universal in all the apps or the system or whatever you are. Function key with letter H will take you to the home screen. Function key with A will show the dock. You can show your app library with shift function key A and all these settings. You can check them in your iPad when you connect a new keyboard, and they have categorized the actions, so you have system and multitasking. Now this is the universal settings which is related to the function key. But if you go inside any application, you have the command key which is related to the application itself. Like if we open Safari here, you press on the command button and you have all the shortcuts for the Safari app. These shortcuts are dedicated to use inside Safari and they are very useful. Of course, you won't memorize all of them, but time after time, you will know which shortcuts you will need the most in every application you use. Like in the Safari, I like to open new tabs using Command T button and to move between tabs by Command 1, 2, 3, 4, like MacBook Pro keyboard. You can use Command L to move directly to the status bar up here. And of course, you can use Command A to select all, Command X to cut, and Command V to paste, and Command C to copy, all the usual suspects that you use on your laptop. Now, I'm not going to be showing you the details of every application. I don't know what you're going to use, and I don't know if the application you use supports the hardware keyboard, but so far most of them do. Now, inside the Safari app, you can see we have new tab, new private tab, open location, open link in backgrounds, open link in new tab, close tab, download link, You can undo, paste and match style, select all dictation, enable dictation, emojis. You can hide the favorites bar and show the sidebar, show tab overview, show history, reopen last closed tab, show bookmarks 1, 2, 3, and edit bookmarks, show reading list, add links to reading list, and show shared with you. You can show previous tab, next tab, show first tab, last tab, and you can change between tabs using the numbers with command. You can open a new empty tab group, show previous tab group, and show next tab group. Too many options, guys. You can check this out on every application you use. Whenever you open an application, it will show you all the options you can use and all the shortcuts you can use on your keyboard, so you'll get the most out of it. Let's try with another app. Let's go for mail, and I like to hit search with command space, mail, and here you go, guys. You can hit the command button again for a couple seconds, and you will see all the settings you have in mail. You have a new message, get all new mail, all the inboxes, or choosing between your email accounts, and you can do a mailbox search or show the sidebar and hide it. Let's go to Notes app, for example. And inside the Notes app, the command key options too, you have a new note, new folder, print, paste and match style, note list search, find in a note, and editing, dictation, emojis. You have font options like bold, italic, underline, title, heading, subheading, body, monospace, dash list, numbered list, checklist, marked as checked, adding a table. You can show the sidebar and hide it. You can view notes as list or gallery, and you can show the attachments browser. Let's go to calendar. And I'm trying to go for the basic apps here. Every app has its different options. Let's hit the command key for 2 seconds again. You can add a new event, you can make a search, show today, refresh calendars, go to next day, week, month, year, or to previous. You can go to day view, week view, month view, year view. You can select the next and previous event. Too many options here. Let's go to the files app. Inside the files app, you also have many options you can use. You can make a new folder, find, paste items, select all. You can hide the sidebar, view as icons, view as list, view as column, view your content as icon, list, column, group, or sort by name, date, kind, size, type, and tags. You can group them by kind and date and size too. You can go to enclosing folder, go to recents, go to documents, go to desktop, go to iCloud Drive if you have one, and you can go to a folder of your choosing or connect to a server. And of course, you can use the arrows to navigate inside your documents. So as you can see, my keyboard of choice is the first generation iMac wireless keyboard. I think it is the best keyboard to use with an iPad because it's a keyboard made for a computer. It's full functioning, the key spacing is great, key travel is good, the stroking is good, typing on it is very comfortable, the build quality is perfect, but the only missing thing would be backlit keys. But it's not that big of a deal. So you can use it as you are used to on your computer, like cut, copy, paste, and taking screenshots, and many more. And has more options specifically for using the iPad with it. And since I had this keyboard, I never felt the need to change it. It's amazing, it's good, and it's slim, it's lightweight. It's very lightweight, you can pack it with your iPad like this, and still it will fit inside an envelope. So that was it for today. Thank you for watching. I always try not to make very long videos, and I'm trying to pack as much info as I can. Don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell. So if you have any question or a different opinion, write it down in the comment below. And I would like to know what is your keyboard of choice. So that was it for today. This was Nibs. Thank you for watching.